I believe that I'm talking to people in the middle of a transition right now, going through a change, going through a shift. Everything's changing. Nothing is stable. Out of a controlled environment, God has taken you out of your comfort zone. There's a certain degree of uncertainty there, a shifting of systems. God's doing something new in your life. You're out of the wilderness. You're facing the promised land. You're too far into it to come out of it, but you're too far out of it to be into it. Do you know what it's like to be betwixt and between two places? I'm not here, but I'm not there. I'm not there, but I'm not over here. The Lord knows where I am. In other words, the Lord knows the way that I take, and when he has tried me, I shall come forth as pure gold. Tell your neighbor, God knows where you're at. Oh, yes. I love people of action. I weary of people who get in your face and tell you what all they're doing and actually doing nothing at all. In my life, results count. I'm impressed by results. Don't tell me what you went through. Tell me you got it done. Not hearers of the word only, but doers of the word. God blesses what you do. And see, when you walk with somebody who is a person of action, and you walk with a do-it man, that spirit will leak out on you. Oh, look at somebody and say, do it. Do it. Do it. Don't dream about it. Don't wish for it. Don't hope for it. Don't long for it. Don't cry about it. Get up and do it. Do it with all of your might and with all of your strength and with all of your passion. Somebody holler, do it. I know you've been through hell. I know you had to go through high water. Didn't think you could swim through it. But I also know there's a reason that you went through everything you went through. After this, you're going to come into your promised land. You're going to see why you had to go through this to get what God is about to do in your life. He didn't take you through that wilderness for nothing. Something good is going to come out of this. You can't let your past destroy your future. You got to get rid of the stuff behind you so you can lay hold to the stuff that's before you. Look at somebody say, get it off you. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but whoever it is, you're getting ready to go to the next level. You're getting ready to go into a brand new dimension of thinking and living and breathing. And a whole lot of things had to change in your life. But the Lord said, after this, get ready, get ready. Some of you have been standing waiting on God to help you. You better go ahead. Slap somebody and say, do it. You've been praying about it, but it's time to do it. You've been waiting on a sign, but it's time to do it. You've been waiting on God to respond, but he already gave you the answer. Do it. Because sometimes a runner can be on his mark and be set to go, and the gun can go off and they can freeze. They're stuck in a state of preparedness, but they never propel into their destiny.
Action. Jesus, the master teacher, said, don't just be listeners, be doers. The world admires the doers.
Give it everything you got. Put your heart in it. Most people, when they're working on dreams, they don't give it everything they have. I heard a guy say in a book, the title of it was, all you can do is all you can do. And all you can do is enough. Most people don't do all they can do. Most people go through life holding back. Answer your calling. Whatever you're called to do, don't count yourself out. Don't say, I can't do that. Many of us go through life saying no, and you don't even know what you're saying no to. You don't know what you cannot do if you're not willing to challenge yourself. Whatever it is that you don't know how to do right now, you can learn. I did not know how to speak for major corporations. I didn't know how to do that, but I decided to become a student. If you do your research, if you do your homework, if you make the commitment that I'm going to learn, when you look at what do I have going for me and drop your buckets where you are, decide I'm going to work and get myself together. A guy named Jim Rohn said, if you develop your gifts will take you places that you'll never begin to imagine.
You want to improve? You want to get better? You want to get on a workout program or a clean diet? You want to start a business? You want to write a book or make a movie or build a house or a computer or put together some mobile application? Where do you start? You start right here. And when do you start? You start right now. You initiate the action aggressively. You go. Because the idea isn't going to execute itself. And the book isn't going to write itself. And the weights out in the gym, they're not going to move themselves. You have to do it. And you have to do it now. You got to stop thinking about it and stop dreaming about it and stop researching every aspect of it and reading all about it and debating the pros and cons of it. Just start doing it. Take that first step and make it happen.
Taking action is part of law of attraction. See, a lot of people think you can just sit in your room, meditate, visualize having the perfect car, the perfect house, the perfect relationship, and then it'll kind of just come to you. And I always say, unless you live at the bottom of a hill where there's a road, it's probably not going to be a Cadillac show up in your living room, right? So think about this. The last six letters of the word attraction spell what? Action. Now, there's two kinds of actions that are critical. There's obvious actions. If you want a certain kind of car, you should go down and test drive it. You should find out how much it costs. You should see what it costs to maintain it. Eventually, you know, those kind of things produce car, right? Saving for it and so forth. But there are also things called inspired actions. All of a sudden, you get an inspiration to do something and you didn't know what it was. You don't have a sense of like, how's this rationally gonna make sense for me to move forward in my life? I'll give you an example. A friend of mine, Dr. Ignatius Piazza, graduates chiropractic school. He wants to move to Monterey near Pebble Beach where the golf course is. And he gets there and he says to the local chiropractic association, I'd like to join you, I'd like you to help me get my practice started. And they said, we don't need any more chiropractors. We have one chiropractor for every eight people in this area. It's too many. Now, he could have said, okay, let the external reality control his internal experience, but he didn't do that. He said, I'm going to think about this and visualize it and believe in it, and something will come that I will do. And what came to him to do was to take 6 months before he opened his office and put a pin where he wanted his office and then concentric circles, knock on every door in every neighborhood saying, hi, I'm a new doctor in town. Could I ask you a few questions? You know, I'm starting this practice. Should I open from 5 till 9 in the morning, or should I be open from 5 until 9 at night for people who have 9-to-5 jobs, which would be better? Should I advertise in this paper or that paper? Should I call it Ignatius Piazza Chiropractic or Chiropractic West? Then his last question was, if I have an open house, would you like to receive an invitation? They said yes, he wrote it down. Now over 6 months, he knocked on 12,500 doors, talked to 6,500 people, and gathered over 4,000 names of people who said, yes, I'd like an invitation to your open house. Now, when he opened his office 6 months later in a town that did not need another chiropractor, according to the professionals, his first month in practice, he netted $72,000. In his first year in practice, his gross income was over $1 million. I was giving a talk and mentioned this story just about 5 years ago, and this happened about 25 years ago. Someone said, he knocked on my door. And he left his card. And 2 years later, I needed the chiropractor, and I called him. Because we work with people we know, we've had an experience with, right? So he trusted his intuition. He took action on it. Other people would say, oh, guess I can't have what I want. You got to be willing to take the action.
Every battle he fought, every pain he'd endured, every love he lost, was just moving him to the place. Suddenly, he understood why things had been so hard and been so long and been so tough. He said, I'm finally in the place of triumph. And that means that I've just now gotten to the place where God could perform his promise in my life. When you're in your place with God, after you've done your trimming and been on your trip, gone through all of your changes, and you understand it's your time, when you get in your place with God, and you will triumph over your enemies. Listen to this. You have finally come to a place that if you just do it, now God is going to bless you.